wants to know what the report, vet report on Pete is. So Pete did go to the vet. I was concerned with his temperature that he may have a urinary tract infection, because when he was out peeing, he would pee for a long time, and then every other step he'd try to pee a little bit more. Though that test result came back fine, he does not have a urinary tract infection. His blood work came back that he has slightly elevated protein, not elevated so much that they're really concerned. He does have some lymph nodes in one of his legs that are slightly swollen, and they did a Lyme test, because that was my other thought. Does he have Lyme? Could that be one of our problems? So they did put him on, the Lyme test came back negative. He does not have Lyme, but that doesn't rule out him having another tick-borne disease. So they are testing for that. They have him on doxycycline, which is a very, very strong antibiotic, but it's also an antibiotic that they use for Lyme disease. So he is on that, and for the first 24 hours, we want to see how he reacts to it. Do we see any signs of improvement? His appetite is good. He is not vomiting. He's just pretty much just lethargic and just chilling out. But he will get up and he will go out with us. He just doesn't do it on his own. We don't see him wandering outside like we normally do. So after 24 hours at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, I need to reevaluate him and give the hospital call. They did do x-rays on him. However, giving a Great Dane x-rays is not easy at all to do. Normally, you would have to sedate the dog. We really didn't want to sedate them. They did the best that they could, getting some chest x-rays and getting some leg x-rays. They are inconclusive. They didn't see anything in there. If he is not showing improvement, he may go back tomorrow and get an ultrasound done. And that is something that you really don't need. The dog can just be laying there, and we can be petting him and talking to him, and they can quickly do the ultrasound. So it's nothing they need.